Alright, so hello guys, and today we're going to be back in FS19. Today we're on the Hagenstead map, classic FS13 map. So, anywho, we've got a truck that basically went off this platform and just slipped right down into this train car here. All it is just kind of leaning in there, not really all the way down in there, which is good to know. I doubt it'd fit in there, to be honest with you. It's actually a pretty slim train car now that I look at it. FS13 quality right there. But anywho, what we're gonna do, I'm gonna use the wrecker here to lift up on this front end. Here. Ooh, I can get this attached while we're looking at it. So I'm gonna get the wrecker to basically more really pull the front end out. Because what I would have to do, I could lift it actually if I move this back a little bit. But pulling might be a better option because I'm gonna actually lift the rear with the rotator. Let me just get the rotator set up here. Okay, not turn it off. Okay. Let me get relatively close, but I did what I did to my FS17 one, which was add the rolling function for the boom. Oh, weird collision he is. I might actually be better off. I have no clue what this collision is, but right here. Oh well. So let's see. How to get it. Basically, just added the rolling function. Limited visibility here. That out later. I think it's on the truck because usually able to ready to go. And then I was going to get one of my friends on, but it's not online right now, so I'm gonna have to do this one solo. But within the next couple of videos I'll probably just start doing multiplayer in FS19. We're trying to just kind of upload both of our mods folders. I've shared my mods folder with him. Now he just has to upload his and share it to me, basically. So, but yeah, the next video, multiplayer. Okay, I'm gonna just get right into it. I'm gonna get some tension on the wrecker. That way, we don't have the front end just slide down in there. Okay, let's go ahead and start lifting. Front end up, and then like I was saying, basically I'm gonna need to retract that end some. Let's see, now that it's leaning, I feel like, yeah, pull it on the front, I'll get it. Then it's gonna act up, of course, because FS19. Gotta love it. Okay, now that I've got the back end in the air, I'm gonna just go ahead and rack and boot them up. Gosh, I don't know what this visibility problem is right here, but. Let's see. It's hard to see what I'm doing, honestly. Wish there was some way to add like a control script, say when you were right here, the mouse controls would show up, but I don't exactly know how the mouse control. I think they're triggered by the, like being in the vehicle, I think. I'm not sure if they're. I know you can trigger an animation from like a little trigger outside of the view. Which a couple done on. Actually, this truck here has one. I'll show you guys one. I'm gonna just literally set this on the platform here. Would be good. I think honestly now I can just pull this front end over this truck. It's gonna go swing in here a little bit. That tire, yep. Ooh! Close to that rigger body. Okay, now let's get this thing to settle out. This is the only thing with the winches on these trucks is like, when something's suspended completely, it tends to freak out because I get the original like winch mod, it pivoted in like two different places, so it was kind of weird, but and it still technically pivots like in two different places. That one spot right there. Honestly, I'm just like boom forward a little bit and just boom. Gotta push it away from my wrecker body here a little bit. Alright, there we go. Hop out real quick and release that cable. Alright. Pull that forward. Alrighty guys, I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, give me a like or a subscribe if you want. And I guess that's it for today, and I'll see you guys in the next one.